Drains that, works out well. And right around where the dozer is in this shot is where that wet spot is. And it turns out just in front of the dozer a little bit, we made another outlet as a contingent outlet after the depressed crossing, which is right around where that tractor is there. And now I'm working to get some massive material to fill that old erosion with, and I'm not too worried about what's in there because I can't do anything about all the brush and the roots and everything. I'll try to get out what I can after I get the dirt off the slope and down into the hole, and I'll compact it, spread it around, back drag it, and you know, try to do the best job I can within the budget that we're operating with. Is a long straightaway, which is above and to the right of the arrow. And below that switchback is what we call rock ramp at the bottom of a cliff. And the point of the arrow is now traveling where the dozer is. And that material is all fairly soft and uncompacted, sitting on the slope there from the original construction of the road. And I'm traveling at about 50 degrees and the machine is sliding pretty bad. I have been testing the slope and how steep it is, see if I can back up, and I can't really. And I've got the blade hooked underneath some bad rock, and I'm lifting the back of the dozer up by lifting up the blade. And I'm gonna basically drop it down and try to shock the rock and break it. And you can see I kind of probably did there. Deciding that those rocks weren't crushing as easily as I had hoped, I'm turning around and kind of doing a couple of odd jobs, pulling dirt back, getting those rippers in position, and I'm going to lower those rippers over those rocks and break them up that way, and then get on top of them when they're a little bit smaller, rather than taking the chance of teetering over and getting high centered on some big old soft rock. Then I can push fairly effectively and get that material off the slope.
Hear the whistle blow.
here I'm doing something different. A lot of loose material sitting on that cut slope that I had made. This is not that real steep slope, but just slightly further down the grade. And I'm just back dragging off of it, take that loose stuff that is going to end up plugging the flow line or just being wasted. And I'm using it in the road grade and packing that berm, the swale that makes the flow line on the left, packing that high point real hard with the tracks by doing what I'm doing. So you need one bend. You got the bend in here. You got the bend.